Prahalada began to grow, and Narada's teachings were showing its results on him. He was a very gentle and noble child, and this made Narada very happy.
Om Brahma Devaya Namaha.
Open your eyes, Hiranyakashipu. I am pleased with your devotion. I haven't seen anyone doing such a severe meditation. Please tell me your desires.
Oh Lord, I want you to give me some boons that I seek.
Hiranyakashipu, you have undertaken such hard meditation that I will surely grant you the boons you seek. Go ahead and ask.
Lord, this is what I seek. Give me the boon that I should not be killed by a man or woman. I should not die either in the house or outside it. I should not die either in the day or in the night. I should not be killed by any weapon, any creature created by you. I should not die either on the land or in the sky. Oh Lord, please grant me these boons.
So be it. I grant you these boons.
After getting boon from Lord Brahma, Hiranyakashipu returned to his kingdom with his wife Kayathu and son Prahalada. The demons were happy to see their king return. The Asuras then narrated to Hiranyakashipu what happened in his absence. Hiranyakashipu burnt with rage.
Listen carefully to what I have to say.
I am virtually ruling all the three worlds. Even heaven is in our hands. But Vishnu is still alive! Not know where he is. He has killed my brother Hiranyaksha, and I'll not sit quietly till I take revenge.
Oh great Lord, I have heard that Vishnu always protects his devotees, and if they are troubled, then I'm sure that Vishnu will appear to protect them.
I like this. This is great! Go and don't leave any of Vishnu's devotees. He will surely come to protect them.
He ordered that each and every person should worship him only, and if anyone disobeys, he should be punished. As the Asuras left to carry out his orders, Hiranyakashipu decided to conquer the whole world by himself. The Asuras of Hiranyakashipu started troubling the people who worshipped God. They forcibly made people to worship Hiranyakashipu. All kinds of God worship was banned. Soon all Vishnu's devotees found themselves in trouble. They were stopped from worshipping their Lord, and those who opposed were brutally killed. Unable to bear the cruelties of Hiranyakashipu, various sages prayed to Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu heard their plea and appeared before them.
I know that you are having tough times, but you have to bear this for some more time. The moment Hiranyakashipu starts troubling his son Prahlad, I will come and punish him for his deeds.
Saying this, Lord Vishnu disappeared, and the sages were relieved after having Vishnu's assurance. Lord Vishnu took Prahlad's name because Prahlad was his devotee, and once Hiranyakashipu comes to know of this, he would not spare his son too.
Son, I have seen that you always sit alone and don't take interest in sports or other activities like other children. Do you want something special from me?
No, Father. I'm happy with whatever I have.
But still I think... Okay. Tell me about something you like most.
Father, I want each and every person to worship and surrender himself to Lord Vishnu.
Seems that someone has misguided you. It's not Vishnu. It's me that everyone should worship and surrender to.
But Lord Vishnu is our protector. He's supreme.
Enough! Go and immediately call Shand and Amark. Tell them I have called them to the palace. Looks as if my son needs some education.
I don't know why he has called us in a hurry. I fear he must be punishing us.
But why?
Gentlemen, you must be knowing why I called you. I have called you to take away my son and educate him as per our culture.
We will educate him as per your order.
You may leave now.
Thus began the education of Prahlad in the ashram. Shand and Amark were instructed to fill hatred against gods in the hearts of the demon students learning there. So they began the education of Prahlad.
Son, as you are new in the ashram, let me just tell you in the beginning that our main aim is to make you understand the difference between a friend and an enemy.
We will let you know how to identify a friend like a demon and an enemy like Vishnu.
Vishnu? But how can our protector be an enemy? After all, he is our Lord.
Don't tell anyone that Vishnu is our Lord.
And never take his name again.
Why should I not take Lord Vishnu's name?
Oh, son, you will be punished.
And he is not our Lord.
Then who is our Lord?
Your father Hiranyakashipu is our Lord.
Yes, he has defeated gods and conquered heaven.
And that Vishnu is a coward. He is hiding from your father.
But he is the greatest and most respected.
If he is the greatest, why doesn't he show up and fight with your father?
Both the teachers told him that Vishnu was the killer of his uncle Hiranyaksha. From that day, Prahlada didn't argue with his teachers